requesting everyone to put your phones on silent, okay? Or vibration. मेरे पास हर सवाल का जवाब नहीं है, बिल्कुल नहीं. हाँ, कुछ तरीके जरूर हैं. अपने आप से जो आप सवाल करते हैं उनके जवाब खुद से ही ढूंढो. Nobody can give you answers for your life. First of all, आपकी लाइफ है, कोई आपको आंसर नहीं दे सकता. Nobody is responsible for your life and for your questions. The only person who has answers for your questions is you. What is required for that is to look deep inside, to have a communication with yourself, to know yourself, to be one with yourself. How to be one with yourself? Bahut simple si ek technique which ma'am also just told you right now, breathing. When you are breathing, when you are practicing your breathing, they say breath is the voice of your soul.
Correct.
You want to listen to your soul? Listen to your breathing. If there's anything wrong with your body, your breathing will tell you. Just close your eyes and listen. That's all you have to do. So, I'm a clinical hypnotherapist and a past life regression therapist. Been seeing people coming from different walks of life. Meeting a lot of different people, army men, journalists, reporters, actors, creative, doctors, so many different people, housewives, students, bachche, they say.
CEO.
Yeah. People who are working in jo buildings are kaam karte hain. And har insaan ko kabhi na kabhi kahin na kahin life mein कुछ इमोशंस हिट करते ही हैं और वो दैट इज इनएविटेबल. वो करेंगे, वो सबको हिट करेंगे, बच्चे से लेकर बड़े तक. हैप्पीनेस तो खैर बहुत जनरल सी चीज़ हो गई. सब हर कोई कहीं ना कहीं, अगर कोई बोले कि मैंने जिंदगी में कभी खुशी देखी ही नहीं, आई डोंट बिलीव इन दैट. देखी होगी, भले ही वो जब इतने से थे और जब पहली बार उन्होंने लिखना ए लेटर लिखना सीखा होगा, वो तब की खुशी क्यों ना, और जब टीचर ने बोला वेरी गुड.
Yes.
That in itself is a happiness for that child, which as we grow up we forget. कि हमारे ऊपर बहुत सारी परतें चढ़ती चली जाती हैं. Expectations की, life की, क्या करना है क्या नहीं करना है, goals की, इच्छाएं, हम ये करना था, oh I'm still stuck here. So we forget those little moments of joy. फिर stress, students से लेके, खासकर students पे तो बहुत ज़्यादा होता है. With all the, जो जिस तरह के मतलब 100% is the catalyst. Wow, who does that? 100%. Everybody has to उन्हीं expectations पे सबको खड़ा उतरना है. सबको 100% चाहिए.
Timer.
सब कोई 100% के लिए भाग रहा है और इसी चक्कर में बहुत सारे बच्चे creativity नहीं करते. They have forgotten the joy of you know just to go out and play. बिकॉज जब हॉलीडेज होते हैं तो उसमें तो होमवर्क मिल जाते हैं, नॉन एज हॉलीडे होमवर्क. देन आता है फिर आपके कॉलेज का टाइम, वहाँ पे स्ट्रेस, अच्छे कॉलेज में जाना है, डॉक्टर बनना है, नहीं नहीं मुझे को जर्नलिस्ट बनना है, नहीं मुझे तो इंजीनियरिंग करनी है, मम्मी ने बोला था बेटा बड़े होकर साइंटिस्ट बनना तो मैं वही बनूंगा. एक्सपेक्टेशंस दूसरों की, अपनी. देन यू ग्रो अप, शादी, फिर वहाँ पे और स्ट्रेस. As you get married, stress. Don't get married, stress. Depression ke bahut sare reasons hai. Amazing amount of reasons. Depending on aap kitne vulnerable hai. It's all about us. Hum kitne vulnerable hai. Bahut sari cheezein aas paas ho rahi hai. Diseases, as we speak, agar hum baat kare medically. Bahut sare diseases, virus har jagah phaile hue hai. हमारा इम्यून सिस्टम कितना स्ट्रांग है या कितना स्ट्रांग नहीं है मेक्स अस मोर रिसेप्टेबल टू दोज डिजीजेज एंड टू दोज वायरसेस. इफ वी आर वर्किंग ऑन आवर इम्यूनिटी बेटर, ईटिंग द राइट फूड, एक्सरसाइजिंग, टेकिंग केयर ऑफ आवर हेल्थ, टेकिंग आवर विटामिंस, कंसल्टिंग अ डॉक्टर एवरी यू नो एवरी मंथ इफ पॉसिबल, एवरी सिक्स मंथ गेटिंग आवर चेकअप डन, इम्यून सिस्टम अच्छा खासा लगा रहेगा. एंड बहुत छोटी छोटी जो बीमारियां जो दूसरों को आसानी से हो जाती हैं, जुकाम खांसी, वो हमको नहीं होगी. ऐसे ही इमोशंस पूरे एनवायरनमेंट में फैले हुए हैं, कलेक्टिव कॉन्शियसनेस में, ऑल दीज इमोशंस आर देयर ऑल अराउंड अस. हम कितने वल्नरेबल हैं, हाउ वल्नरेबल आर वी टू कैच दोज इमोशंस एज वायरसेस. इफ आई एम बाय डिफॉल्ट बाय माय नेचर, इफ आई एम अ हैप्पी पर्सन, मेरे आसपास मोमेंट्स आएंगे जब चीजें अच्छी नहीं होंगी, बट बिकॉज माय नेचर डीप विद इन आई एम अ हैप्पी पर्सन, आई मे गेट अ लिटिल डिस्टर्ब बाय देम, बाय देम से आई एम सैड and you know I start questioning myself for a while, but it will not cause me depression. I'll eventually know ki theek hai, when I've done pretty well for myself in life, aage badho mitti na. Ya phir agar if I'm a calm person aur agar stress ki situation aayegi, again thode se kahin na kahin wo vibrations create honge in my mind, I'll be like uff dimag ghum raha hai, but eventually I'll know how to manage it because my immune system is strong spiritually, emotionally. Emotional immunity, spiritual immunity, that's pretty strong. So yes, emotions are everywhere. And as humans, we are all allowed to feel those emotions. We are allowed to cry. We are allowed to feel sad. Well, you know, with all this talk of, I am happy, I choose to be happy. Why? It's okay. You are going through a certain thing currently. Life mein kuch choti bahut cheeze chal rahi hai. Feel it. We are humans. That's what we do. We feel. We are feeling beings. You're feeling sad? Cry. Let it out. But when you cry, make sure that you cry properly. Usi time sab roke nikal do. Let it out. So that when you get out of that state and when you step out, you say, okay, I've picked myself up. Cleansed. So I was watching a beautiful show, cooking show by Gordon Ramsay. अगर आप लोगों ने सुना है Gordon Ramsay, crazy chef. So उनके एक शो में one of his chefs, कुछ हुआ उसकी उंगली कट गई, ये हो गया, उसका बहुत कुछ गड़बड़ हो रहा था, and she just fell down and she said, I can't do this anymore, I am depressed, I don't want to do this, I'm done, मुझे नहीं करना है, I'm done, I am a loser. So Gordon came. And Gordon looked at her and said, you're feeling sad? And she's crying. She said, yes. You want to cry? Yes. Okay. Cry. I'm not going to pick you up. I'm not going to tell you to stop crying. You had 1 hour to prepare this dish. 10 minutes already gone. Take your time. Still, cry. But when you are done, pick yourself up and get back in the game or get out. Right now. But when you cry, you cry. It's okay. There are moments when people keep telling you, choose to be happy, choose to be happy. I don't want to choose to be happy. I don't want to feel this emotion. Okay, feel. Depression, as we talk about it, in medical terms, clinical depressive behavior attitude. Right? Where you are clinically, mentally depressed in the sense that you stop losing, or you start losing interest in everything, वो चीजें जो आपको पहले भी पसंद हैं. कई बार clinical depression का कोई reason नहीं होता. People who are clinically depressed, if you ask them, उनकी life में सब अच्छा चल रहा है. Husband loves them, mother loves them, children love them. अब गाड़ी है, BMW, Mercedes and Mustang and you name it, and they have everything. Materialistic चीजों से लेके emotional support सब कुछ है, but even then they are depressed. You don't always need a reason for depression. People like that don't always need a reason for depression. They could be coming from a lot of things. Maybe they have a history of depression in their family. Medically, clinically depressed, the depressed person in the family. They're carrying it genetically. Okay. Maybe they are going through menopause or some hormonal changes in their body. Medically, yes, kuch na kuch reasons ho sakte hai, jo ki unke hormones ko, you know, they're mixing up their hormones and they're feeling that way. That kind of depression is also treatable. Of course, there's medicines. People say ki dawaiyan mat, you know, dawaiyan avoid karo, don't go on antidepressants. I say the opposite. Even though I don't recommend medicines myself, I don't suggest, I do not have the authority and I don't even know this thing medically. But even then when people come and say ki mujhe to bola tha ki aap medicine mat lena aur bimar pad jaoge. You have a headache. if you don't take a medicine at that point of time, when it's extreme, it can be dangerous, it can be fatal. It can turn into anything for all you know. For that moment, you need a medicine. You need to pop a pill maybe for a few hours for it to calm down. By the time, kya hota hai? Aisa nahi hai ki wo dard chala gaya. It just comes the nerve, am I correct? Wo us moment ke liye wo numb ho jata hai. So you can better deal with it. So when people are taking antidepressants, it's all right too. It's okay. It's just numbing that emotion for that moment so that you can think of other things, deal with that situation in that moment and get over it slowly. And the doctors always, they taper it, dheere dheere karte karte, wo kam kar dete hai medicines. That's perfectly fine. Then there are ways to deal with it without medication. With meditation. Exercising. Because as we exercise, we run, jo chemicals produce hote hain with running, they are such amazing antidepressants. Wow, the surge of energy we feel when we exercise. Awesome. So I'm going to start with one story. One that talks about depression and one that talks about sadness. An emotion, just to differentiate between the two, to understand, to know ki agar aapke aas paas bhi koi aisa hai, who comes up with these triggers? How can you help them? So there was this man who came home. And he said, I have stopped doing everything that I used to do suddenly. Beech mein bas ek episode hua ki jab mera operation tha. And operation ke time pe anesthesia ke se, when I was coming out of the effect of anesthesia, तो उस टाइम पे मुझे थोड़े से हैलुसिनेशंस ऐसे हुए कि मैं घबरा गया. कुछ हुआ, मैं घबरा गया. मुझे लगा कि जैसे आसपास कोई, आई वाज इन ऑपरेशन से निकल के आया था तो आसपास कोई नहीं था एंड मैं एकदम डर गया. आई वाज नर्वस. उसके बाद से मेरे साथ ऐसा हो गया है कि आई हैव स्टार्टेड लूजिंग इंटरेस्ट इन एवरीथिंग, इवन दोस थिंग्स जो मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगती थी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, टेकिंग माई सन आउट इन द मॉर्निंग, एवरी मॉर्निंग फॉर अ वॉक. For example, मुझे वायलिन बजाने का शौक था, स्टॉप प्लेइंग द वायलिन. मुझे घूमने का शौक था, मैंने घूमना बंद कर दिया. मुझे अच्छे खाना खाने का शौक था, मैंने वो बंद कर दिया. I just had lost interest. I stopped sleeping. I don't remember कि मैं आखिरी बार अच्छे ठीक तरीके से कब सोया था. कोई रीजन नहीं है, सब अच्छा है. Family is very supportive. Everybody is good. I have been on antidepressants also, he said. But even they don't seem to work. In fact, with antidepressants, he was feeling even more lethargic because that's one of the side effects. So, and he said, when I feel lethargic, I feel even more depressed. फिर मुझे लगता है कि I'm hopeless, I'm useless, nothing can be done, कुछ कर ही नहीं सकता. In that situation, what I suggested him was, of course, some good meditation techniques that help him, some visualization techniques that we will be discussing today also, by the way. I'll be teaching you those techniques so you can use them for yourself, or you can tell others to, you know, use this technique for this kind of work. It took about 8 sessions to work with him. After 8 sessions, by the 5th session when he came back, he reported that maine wapas se violin utha liya. मुझे बस ये समझ में आ रहा है कि कुछ तो हुआ है, मुझे नहीं पता क्या हुआ है, बट मैंने वापस से वायलिन उठा लिया. एंड हालांकि आप टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम स्क्वायर ए, क्योंकि मैं काफी कुछ भूल गया, बट आई हैव पिक्ड इट अप अगेन. गुड थिंग. सेकंड दैट ही रिपोर्टेड वाज दैट ही स्टार्टेड ईटिंग द फूड दैट ही एंजॉयड. वी वर्क्ड अ लिटिल बिट, आई वर्क्ड अ लिटिल बिट ऑन हिज स्लीप पैटर्न, गिविंग हिम सम एक्सरसाइजेस टू स्लीप बेटर, बिकॉज़ एज वी स्लीप the body and the mind, we heal ourselves as we sleep. And some positive suggestions to listen to that are recorded while he was sleeping, so that those suggestions kept going in his subconscious. So ye to hui ek story which is of a depression person who said clinically depressed, been taking antidepressants and everything, which I understood ki theek hai, this is depression, makes sense, all the symptoms that he was showing were of depression. In the second story, this girl of about 28, she came to me. And she said, I am clinically depressed. Aate, she said, I am clinically depressed. I said, okay. Who has done the diagnosis? First it was me, and then Google told me. What did Google tell you? I said, I just put in the symptoms. And so Google said, depression.
You're depressed.
I said, thank God Google did not say you have AIDS. It would have been horrible. And then she said, no, then I went to one of my friends also. She is a psychologist. And she said, haha, you to say, hey, you are depressed. Very good. And then I wanted to know what happened. How did, why was she doing the research on am I depressed, clinical depression? Why was she taking all those online questionnaires of depression? So I asked her, when did you start taking this questionnaire? When did you start doing this research on depression? She said, about 4 months back. So I asked her, what happened 4 months back? She said, I had a twin sister and she passed away in an accident. 4 months back, my twin sister passed away. And we used to sleep in the same room, share the same room, and she passed away. And since then, I have not been able to feel, you know, otherwise when I go out, I'm okay. I meet people and everything, but then when I come back home, I miss her and I cry.
What was her age?
28. Then I come back home and I cry, because I miss her. I said, and you thought that it's depression? She said, yes. Now, coming back to what we started with, you're allowed to feel sad. When it comes to the death of a loved one, you know, losing a loved one, somebody that you dearly love, when it comes to losing a person like that, we are bound to feel sad. She had grown up with that twins, playing together, sharing memories together, creating memories together. So many wonderful things that they've done together. Sleep in the same room, probably wear the same clothes. So when she used to come back home, she used to miss talking to her sister at night, which she often did, fighting with her also. And she thought that, you know, because I'm crying when I come back home, and because I feel sad, and because the questionnaire that I took on Google, the quiz, the puzzle, said that I'm depressed, or I am depressed. That is where we need to understand the difference between the two, depression and sadness. Emotions. Depression is that extreme sadness that cannot be controlled and that disturbs your complete routine. Things that you would otherwise do perfectly well, it disturbs that routine. You stop eating, you put on weight or you lose weight. Either you eat a lot or you don't eat a lot, or you don't eat at all. Things that were, you know, affecting your work, affecting studies, affecting everything, affecting your body. That extremity of experiencing that emotion is depression. Sadness is one of those many emotions that go to that extreme level as we experience depression. Sadness is okay and can be controlled. Perfectly fine. Having said that, I'm going to talk a little bit about where these emotions are stored. Ye kaha hota hai sari cheezein. It's important. So, this is something that I work on.
You can put something behind it so that.
Isko thoda sa piche karo.
Yes.
Isko na.
Why the triune mind? Three levels. This minion-like structure you see here. This is the conscious mind. That's your subconscious mind. And this is your superconscious mind. So in what I do in my practice, we don't believe in an unconscious. We are never unconscious. We are always in some or the other state of consciousness. Levels of awareness. Even when we are knocked out, anesthesia or otherwise, even then we are in some or the other state of awareness. Conscious mind is your questioning mind, reasoning mind, analytical mind, monkey chattering mind. Sahi hai, galat hai, kya karna hai, kya nahi karna hai, dhobi, kapda, makan. Everything that is the conscious mind. This is where all the five senses are stored as well. physical sensations. It puts logic into things, reasons, questions. That's all that it does. Blah, blah, blah. Then comes your subconscious mind. Now, subconscious mind starts forming when we are 3 months fetus. And you would agree with that. So the story we heard, the Chakravyuh story, makes complete sense now, doesn't it? Subconscious mind starts forming when the child is 3 months in the mother's womb. This is where all the emotions are stored. So depression, a condition I would say, caused by certain emotions, stress, anxiety, sadness. Happiness as an emotion, fear as a sensation again, caused by some other things. Everything is all stored here. And these emotions are a result of the different memories that we grow up with. Things that we experience growing up, that we see. The programmings that are given to us by the people around us. Because as children, unke liye peers, authority figures, teachers, mummy, papa, they are the best examples. Na? Bacche ko bola gaya ki, you are very smart. The child is like, yes, I'm very smart. Grows up thinking I'm very smart. If a child is constantly told, you're stupid, you are dumb, no matter how intelligent the child is and grows up to be, will always keep believing, no, but my parents told me, used to tell me that I'm dumb. I am. So that communication with children is extremely important. And वो कहते हैं ना कि 6-7 साल की उम्र तक जो आपकी प्रोग्रामिंग घर पे होती है, those are the best years of your life. That is where you learn the most. That's true, and we'll also get to the reason of why that is true. Now, our beliefs are also stored here. I am depressed is a belief. I am clinically depressed. Google told me so. A belief created by people around me. Google Anand for all the things and the things that I've heard. Oh, usko to wo ladki wo bahut sone lagi thi to aisa ho gaya tha to usko wo doctor ke paas gayi unko antidepressant de diya. Oh, so this is what happens, huh? Depression. I'm feeling the same way. It's a belief that has been created by what I've heard and what I've started believing. So, which brings us to behavior. As humans, we behave according to what we believe in. If I'm a Hindu, and tomorrow somebody says, you are going to, from tomorrow, wear a burqa and do the namaz five times a day. Panch waqt ki namaz padhoge aap aur aap burqa pehnoge. Now, I may read the Quran because it's a text, it's a study, it's a philosophy. I'll enjoy reading it, ki theek hai, I'm reading it as a text. I'll not be able to follow those rules and regulations because that is not my belief system. I've grown up in a completely belief system, a completely open belief system. Burqa, parda, no. As is with so many of our beliefs, right? So we behave according to what we believe in. If I start believing I am depressed, I will behave like a depressed person. If I start believing I'm a loser, I will behave like a loser. On the other hand, if my belief system is, I am the best, in no matter what I do, then no matter what I do, I will be the best at it because that is what I believe about myself. And I will function from that level of belief system. So, all of these things put together, emotions, learned through memories, creating our belief systems, creating our behaviors, they create our personality in the subconscious level of awareness. Every personality has different patterns and traits of its own. Some are positive patterns, some are negative patterns. Fear is a negative pattern. A sad behavior is a positive pattern, or positive personality trait, a negative personality trait. Ugh. Love
positive.
Is positive. Joy, kindness, all positive. All of it is stored at the subconscious level of awareness. Cool? Till now? The conscious mind is highly governed by these programmings of the subconscious mind. Consciously, we behave according to these programmings that are stored here at this level. Can that be changed? Hell yeah. Absolutely be changed. The language of the subconscious mind is visual. So whatever that we perceive visually, jo bhi kuch hum visually perceive karte hain, the subconscious mind does not know how to put that in the fact or fiction bracket. Nahi pata, watching a horror movie. We know it's a movie. Ghost heads in the movie, but we get scared. Even entering the bathroom after watching the movie is so scary. Right? All of that is because while we are watching the movie, we are at the subconscious level of awareness. Not thinking consciously. Because movies are one thing that hum log jab jaate hain to dimag ki baaki sari chinta hata ke chalo movie dekhne jaate hain. Let's just enjoy. So we don't sit and question the movie unless and until yeah, we are really critical in our nature. But
bahar baithoge.
Then bahar hi baithoge fir ab nahi jaoge dekhne ke liye. But if you've gone to see that movie, you've got to enjoy that movie. Ki chhodo na baaki sab. So consciously you're not thinking, questioning, वो नहीं चल रहा है यहाँ पर सब कुछ लग रहा है असली है एक साउंड कहीं से आती है इवन यू यू नो अगेन आई एम कमिंग बैक टू हॉरर मूवीज बिकॉज ऑफ द इमोशन द इंटेंस इमोशन दैट इंफ्लुएंस इन अस सामने मूवी चल रही है किसी की वहां बॉटल गिर जाती है एंड वी स्क्रीम लगता है कि भूत आ गया दैट इज हाउ कितने एक्सट्रीम पे हम इमोशंस को एक्सपीरियंस करते हैं When we are experiencing those emotions at the subconscious level, that is the intensity of every emotion that we experience. Okay? Now, moving on to the superconscious, and this is the most beautiful level of awareness, divine. One word for which is soul. You want to be scientific about it? Let's call it energy. Science has said, I'm not saying it. Energy does not die, it only transforms from one form to another form. We are energy beings at our core. So if this energy is right now in the form of Dr. Lakshmi. When Dr. Lakshmi as a form did not exist, the energy still existed in another form. As Dr. Lakshmi as a form will cease to exist, like every other form, the energy will continue to exist in another form. With each form, the energy is carrying the experiences, the memories, and all of these personality traits that were at the subconscious level of that form. Why it is important for that to also carry is for growth. The only purpose of every energy is to grow. As we grow, continue to grow through experiences, lifetimes, learning different things, new things, practicing the old ones, everything put together, prodigies as we say, jab humko chote chote bache we see on reality shows, who are so amazingly gifted and we wonder, bache ne kahin sikha nahi, still is singing so well. In this life, that energy is in this form, was just practicing that technique more and more and getting better with it. With each lifetime getting so much better, right? As that energy continues to grow, eventually wo badhte badhte badhte, blast happens and that energy then divides itself to smaller energy forms. And then those energy forms continue to have an experience of their own. So as we speak of moksha, it's nothing but then expanding to that level that the energy says, ha, abhi jo sikhna tha sikh liya, now these small little energy forms that are around that I am made up of, they need to have an experience of their own. So, go. So that God particle we keep talking of, we are that God particle. That is what God is, right? A huge energy form that has divided itself into many other energy forms and we are just having the experience of it. Of all the lifetimes. So, superconscious soul energy. Right? Superconscious has certain characteristics of its own. love, peace, grace, forgiveness, intuition. That's six sense we have, right? कितनी बार we feel मुझे लगा था ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए था but I still did it and then we regret क्योंकि अंदर से आवाज आ रही थी नहीं करना चाहिए था या फिर we say I knew this was going to happen. That's your soul. Creativity,
happiness,
joy
and happiness,
courage, more
knowledge,
yes,
power of God,
yes,
God's
wisdom, positivity. Keep adding. That's all the superconscious mind.
All the words.
God's wisdom.
Yes, precisely. So we are at our own little level, God's in our complete being. So, what's there to be depressed about?
Exactly.
Life is cool. Life is beautiful.
Take out those.
Yes. Now, but why do people depressed? The subconscious mind, however, cannot control the superconscious mind, but the superconscious mind gets affected by these
external factors,
negative programmings of the subconscious mind. How? When we are sad, we are not identifying in that
moment
with the joy programming of the superconscious mind. When we are in fear, we are not identifying with our courage programming. Whatever negative we are experiencing or we experience at any point of time in life is because we simply stop identifying with it because we are so focused on this
negative.
Because we are such visual beings. That's why when Dr. Sharda Jain was telling you about that breathing exercise, remember, so the breath is the voice of your soul. We are constantly focused on the voice of the subconscious mind and not doing anything about the voice of the soul. Not breathing. We are breathing, but we are not even aware of it. Nahi pata.
And when we become aware of it, we breathe the wrong way.
And we breathe the wrong way. We are doing all sorts of things. No, calm it. It's beautiful. The language of the soul is beautiful. Pay attention, listen. Everything is in control. Life is in control. We have the control simply by choosing to be in control. If you're choosing not to feel happy in one particular moment, good. At least you're making that choice. Then take responsibility for it and stop blaming. People need to stop blaming the surroundings around them. Oh, I'm sad because of this. No. I'm sad because I'm looking at sadness and because I'm choosing to be sad. I have the power to stop looking at the things that make me sad, and I hold the power to focus on my breath and tune into this and raise my vibration at this level. We have that power. Now, you've all heard about the secret, law of attraction. Most of us have. Law of attraction ka symbol sa panda, what you think is what we become.
When the doctor community here must know, we invite all our problems. We invite our diseases, we invite cancer, we invite everything. We only invite.
With emotions. Emotions like stress, anxiety, guilt, sadness, depression, cancer. I was reading somewhere, the biggest cause of cancer in most people is guilt.
60% of the people in the oncology cancer hospitals admitted that guilt.
Yes. Guilt. True. They hold the guilt so much in their system. A lot of times, you know, the cause for throat cancer is the guilt of not being able to speak up. Or because they have been told to shut up their entire lives. So they hold all that stress, all those emotions here. Don't talk.
वो गुटका भी है
यार बिल्कुल है एज वी टॉक ऑन द इमोशनल लेवल आई मीन ऐसे भी लोग हैं ना जो गुटका नहीं खा रहे टेकिंग केयर ऑफ देयर हेल्थ सब कुछ अच्छा खा रहे हैं पी रहे हैं सब कुछ कर रहे हैं फिर भी एंड देन यू कीप वंडरिंग कैसे आई हैव बीन टेकिंग केयर ऑफ माय लाइफ एवर सिंस एंड आई एम How? They need to tune into their emotions, those emotions that they have blocked or have overthought, right? It's those emotions that have taken up so much in their lives that they develop a disease out of it. So as doctors, you're going to have patients with so many other things, you know, ailments coming to you, ye problem ho gaya, pain ho gaya, pains. Talk about emotions. A lower back pain is most of the times, it's an emotion, also financial insecurity. A lot of people who have financial insecurity will have lower back pains. Or who are insecure about, you know, a lot of things in their lives. The insecure people. When it comes to pain here, it's because they feel suppressed. Emotionally, they have been suppressed in their families. यहाँ दर्द रहता है कंप्लेनिंग ऑफ पेन व्हेन इट कम्स टू हियर दिस पोर्शन इज ऑल अबाउट अगेन पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स नॉट हैप्पी इन देयर पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स
इट कैन बी एज रिलेटेड आल्सो
या वेल इफ इट इज नॉट एज रिलेटेड
आई एम मेडिकल थेरेपी फॉर ऑल अबाउट दिस
एंड इवन इफ यू फील इट इज एज रिलेटेड यू कैन रिवर्स दैट टू
करेक्ट
Maybe with age,
medical disease.
It could not have. You know, there are so many people who are, jinki age kafi hai, but there no pain in their body. It's because they've learned to live a happy life.
Mind you, you are talking to doctors.
Yes, sir.
The psychosomatic disorders. Hai, what she is talking. About.
Absolutely. We're talking about the emotions here. Okay. Now. Coming to, as I was speaking with you, law of attraction, a lot of people have heard about it. And some people have come to me saying, it has failed in my life. I keep telling myself, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy, but I don't feel happy. Why? So do you see this over here? This is called the critical factor of the mind. Critical factor starts developing when we are 6 or 7 years old. Starts developing. It's completely developed by the time we turn 12 or 13. So that saying, 6-7 saal ke jo bachche ki umr hoti hai, jo ghar mein wo seekh leta hai, wo zindagi bhar uski life mein rehta hai, true. Critical factor tab tak nahi hota. Iska matlab kya hai? Let's put it simply. Aap ek cup mein chai daal rahe hain, par aapke paas chhanni nahi hai. So chai patti, adrak, ilaichi, everything goes in the cup. That is what is happening to us, has happened to us. And is happening to a lot of children. जो भी इस साल इस उम्र तक से पहले जो भी उनको बताया जाता है वो सब अंदर जा रहा है उनको नहीं डिफ्रेंशिएट करना आ रहा काफी टाइम तक सही गलत में कितने सारे यू नो भी सो कितने छोटे बच्चे होते हैं वो उठाते हैं देख रहे कॉकरोच जा रहे हैं उठा के मुंह में डाल देते हैं दे डोंट नो उनको नहीं पता उनको देखा कुछ है जो भी है पता नहीं दे डोंट नो उनको नहीं पता डिफरेंस बिटवीन गुड बैड एग्जिस्ट नहीं करता है उसके लिए वो सर इट्स ओनली एज दे ग्रो पेरेंट्स ने बोला बेटा गंदी बात तो समझ में आता है अच्छी गंदी बात टीचर ने बोला कि तुमने होमवर्क नहीं किया तुमको होमवर्क करना है तो तुमको मार्क्स मिलेंगे नहीं करोगे तो डांट मिलेगी तो मैं कैसे होमवर्क ये चीज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वहां से समझ में आई लेकिन किस तरह से वो समझाया जा रहा है दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रेनिंग किड्स टू बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल विद अ फट्टा And training kids to be responsible by giving them rewards. Two different things. And that's how they grow up. So, depression, again, is not something jo ki bahut bade ho ke life mein aata hai. Bahut sare factors involved hote hain. Kai baar, yahan se bhi aa jata hai. As an example, I have this, not just one, but so many people who have come to me saying that they are depressed And they've never felt, they have experienced moments of joy, but they've never felt happiness as such. Because as they were growing up, their parents, you know, some, yeah, the mother, your father, have treated them badly. And one girl who came and she just came and she cried and she said, you know, when my mother, jabhi bhi main achhe marks nahi lati thi, she used to hit me, beat me, jo bhi milta tha phek ke maar deti thi, garam chimta tak mujhe maar ke, she used to lock me in the room and not give me anything to eat till the time I would swear that next time achhe marks lekar aaungi. Ya till the time main agar 10 maths ke problem yaad nahi kar leti thi. और वो मुझे याद भी नहीं होते थे क्योंकि मैं इतना स्ट्रेस में होती थी, इतनी डरी हुई होती थी कि वो याद ही नहीं होते थे, तो फिर और पढ़ती थी, मुश्किल से एक रोटी मिल जाती थी खाने को. अदरवाइज शी वॉज ऑल्सो केप्ट लॉक्ड इन द डॉग केज फॉर 2 days बाय हर मदर बिकॉज शी वॉज नॉट स्टडिंग. सो एज शी ग्रू अप एज अ वेरी डिस्टर्ब्ड पर्सन. Eventually, finally, she later realized ki uski mother ko, she was bipolar. Her mother had bipolar disorder. So that's why she used to do it. When she realized, she eventually could forgive her, but for personality mentality. So, although forgive kar chuki thi, and although now she's, you know, she's doing well for herself, but that belief system that wo store ho gaya tha uske mind mein, in the absence of critical factor, I'm useless. I'm worthless. I'm a bogey on this planet. Caused her to feel depressed all the time. So whenever, even though somebody would try to tell her, you're so intelligent, you're smart, and which she is, intelligent, smart, beautiful, she would not believe that. Because after the age of 12 or 13, the critical factor jab puri tarah se develop ho jata hai, then it becomes a gatekeeper. Now what does a gatekeeper do? Unless and until यहाँ पे information हो, so आपके people who live in societies, या फिर even दो जिनके colonies में जिनके घर पे house helps हैं, घर पे कोई आया घंटी बजी, you're first asked, या तो phone करके कि वो आए हैं भेजते हैं, अगर आप already familiar है या जानते हैं कि हाँ ठीक है भेज दीजिए, या फिर यूँ से कि हाँ वो कुछ तो मंगाया था Amazon से, so they let that person in. Right? Otherwise, if you say, नहीं हम तो नहीं जानते, कौन है उनको वहीं रोको, नहीं नहीं उनको अंदर मत आने देना, we'll throw it out. उसके माइंड में ऐसा है ही नहीं stored कि I'm intelligent. उसके माइंड में तो यही stored है, I'm worthless, useless, horrible, to be treated like an animal. So when she is treated rightly by someone, she starts doubting that person. If somebody treats her with love, her personality had become such कि she's doubting love. You know, you are treating me with love. Am I your pet? She used that statement so many times. You know, my ex-boyfriend treated me like a pet. And later when I asked her, slowly we went back to her memories. That was when she told me that she was locked in the cage for 2 days when she was all of 7.5 years old. Pet. Am I your pet? Am I your dog? She used another word, which I'll not use here. But this was a programming cause her to feel depressed. Now, critical factor has developed, become a gatekeeper. So, law of attraction, as she kept saying, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy, did not work for her because this affirmation that she was giving herself, this suggestion that she was giving to herself, I'm happy, was being stopped by the critical factor every time. Saying, no, you are not, look deep inside. I'm successful. No, you are not, you're a loser. I'm loved. No, you are not. You need to be treated like a dog locked in the cage. Which means, to get here and to reverse these things, yes, everything can be reversed. As doctors, illnesses too can be reversed. And you know that. You have done that. Treated so many people. Made so many people better. Healed so many people. So if that can be done with medicines, that can also be done with meditation. What we need to do is to relax the critical factor of the mind. How to do that? Breathing. So important. As I said, breathing, so many people just said, yes, breathing. Breathing, what it does is allows us to relax, allows us to focus within, allows us to listen to what this guy, beautiful little fellow, is saying over here. As we breathe, the body relaxes. So abhi when jab aapko 2 minute sirf breathe karwaya ja raha tha, so many people were straight baithe just went like this. And they were so relaxed. I was watching. Aram se pehle seedha baithe tanke. Okay, doctor, ma'am ne bola hai seedha baithna. Yes. 2 minute, 30 seconds. By the end of it, they were like, somebody yawned. It is beautiful. The body relaxes. When the body relaxes, the brain, which you guys know better, as any other organ in the body, your kidneys, liver, jo bhi hai, the brain relaxes too. Brain ka kaam kya hota hai? Most functions, sabse zyada jo function hota hai, is to control your body movements, nodding the head.
Motor and sensitive.
Yes.
Motor and sensitive.
Yes. So the brain relaxes. क्योंकि ब्रेन के पास अब कुछ आ नहीं गया उनको तो इज लाइक नाउ व्हाट डू आई डू ओके सो आई जस्ट रिलैक्स एज द ब्रेन रिलैक्सेस द कॉन्शियस माइंड बिकॉज इट एनालाइजेस वेरी गुड एनालाइजर द एनालिटिकल कॉन्शियस माइंड हैज एनालाइज्ड दैट द बॉडी इज रिलैक्स्ड द ब्रेन इज रिलैक्स्ड व्हिच मींस दैट द एनवायरनमेंट इज सेफ फॉर मी टू रिलैक्स कॉन्शियस माइंड कैन ओनली रिलैक्स व्हेन द एनवायरनमेंट इज सेफ और व्हेन वी आर विलिंग ऑफ experiencing that state of relaxation. Okay? When that happens, the conscious mind relaxes. So, conscious mind ke relax hone ka matlab thoughtlessness to nahi hai. We can never be thoughtless. I am thoughtless is also a thought. Hota kya usually jab hum thoughtless ho jate hain, achanak thought aati hai, oh! Boom, thought. So, it's okay. In the state of that state of relaxation when the conscious mind is relaxed, in fact, thoughts itni sari hoti hai. Kyunki achanak se na peeche se achanak se lagta hai ki, oh bhai saab relax ho gaya, bhago, let's go. When that happens, thoughts keep coming and going, coming and going, coming and going. Usually hum kya karte hain? In an aware state, hum kisi ek thought ko pakad ke baith jate hain. Aur usi ke baare mein sochte rehte hain. Which leads to also obsessive thinking. Yehi hota hai. आज खाने में क्या बनना है तो यहाँ पे बैठे बैठे रेसिपी तक बन चुकी है बस जाना है और कढ़ाई गर्म करनी है राइट एक थॉट को पकड़ के बैठे हुए हैं यू सिटिंग हियर मेरी गाड़ी ठीक से पार्क है तो नहीं हो जाएगी बैठे हुए इन द स्टेट ऑफ दैट रिलैक्सेशन व्हाट हैपेंस इज इतनी सारी थॉट्स आते हैं कि उनको पकड़ने का टाइम नहीं होता दे कम एंड दे गो इससे पहले आप उनको पकड़ पाओ निकल जाती है दूसरी थॉट Which is fine. Because hote hote, it's like, I wonder how many of you have seen the Matrix? So, Matrix mein wo numbers nahi flash karte. Aap kisi number ko samajh pao, isse pehle those numbers are gone. That's exactly what happens. You could before you can understand anything, it's gone. Then what happens is the critical factor now has understood. Gatekeeper ko samajh mein aa gaya, safe. So it is safe for me to put my gun. To put my guards down for a while. It's okay. Because this person is willingly doing this, knows that it can lead to a complete state of probably can make this person sleep and is okay with it, then I'm going to let my guards down. So the critical factor relaxes. And when this happens, we can easily enter here. Reverse what need to
be
reversed
by auto-suggestions.
Self-suggestion. That's all we are doing all the time. We are suggesting ourselves 24/7. I'm thirsty is a suggestion for somebody to get up from here, go out and get a glass of water. It's hot is a suggestion for me to open my jacket and say, oh, it is hot. I'm hungry is a suggestion for me to pick up my phone, either order food or to just go out and eat something, get myself something to eat, fix myself a meal. Auto-suggestion is happening 24/7. Usi auto-suggestion mein kitne sare negative ho jate hain. और वहीं से यहाँ पे जाके स्टोर हो जाते हैं वी डोंट इवन रियलाइज सो मेनी थॉट्स कीप कमिंग छोटी छोटी चीजें गुस्सा आ गया किसी पे ड्राइव करते हुए गाड़ी ठोक दी वो एक थॉट आके बैठ गई कि अब तो मुझे बदला लेना है तो वो बदला यूजुअली क्या होता है बहुत सारे लोग व्हाट दे मे बी नॉट अस मे बी नॉट यू एंड आई बट दे वुड कम बैक होम एंड येल एट द फर्स्ट पर्सन दे सी क्या जूते कैसे रखे हैं ये एंड देन यू वंडर व्हाट व्हाट डिड आई डू बाद में पता चलता है कि जब वो गाड़ी ठोक दी थी किसी ने होते होते किस तरह से थॉट्स कहाँ पे आके निकलते हैं, वो डोंट इवन रियलाइज. डिप्रेशन इज वन ऑफ दोज मेनी थॉट्स. बिलीफ, इट इज अ बिलीफ, यस. सो मेनी इमोशंस पुट टुगेदर, ऑल दोज इमोशंस टू आर अ बिलीफ सिस्टम. बिलीफ्स कैन बी रिवर्स्ड इजीली. हाउ? So that state of relaxation, that naturally relaxed state of body and mind that we are talking about, well, is also the definition of hypnosis. Hypnosis is a naturally relaxed state of body and mind. So sitting here, what you were doing right now for 2 minutes was a state of self-hypnosis. Law of attraction, when it starts working, is while that was happening for those 2 minutes while you were breathing, if you were to enjoy that state and start telling yourself good things, I choose to be relaxed in that state. I choose to be relaxed. Okay, so I am relaxed. And then you observe yourself. Am I relaxed? No, it feels good. So now I tell myself I choose to be happy. If that is what I really choose. And take responsibility for that. I choose to be happy. It's my choice to be happy. I choose to be kind and loving. I choose to look at situations as opportunities of growth. And that's what we do. So instead of things affecting me in a way that I get sad and depressed, things are now affecting me in a way that I'm looking at something for me to grow. This will help me grow. A bad situation, awesome, another opportunity to grow. I'm stuck in my life, wonderful, let's learn out of it. Then that becomes the way you behave. Because your beliefs have been reversed. So you start behaving that way. When that happens, you are in tune with all of these positive attributes, these virtues of the soul, of the superconscious, of the energy. And that creates a wonderful change within and around you. So even if you come in the company, you know, some people come to you and they are sad and they are negative, you can change them by simply being in their presence. So many gurus do that. You know, so many spiritual gurus, you just sit next to them and you feel like, because their vibrations are so beautiful. They have worked on themselves here. And that is what they are throwing out into the universe. Yes, depression is not a huge thing. It's nothing that cannot be controlled. No, it's not. Whoever says it is, don't listen to them. Because if you listen to them, that becomes your belief. Because you're agreeing with what they have to tell you about depression. What do you believe about depression? Is it an opportunity to grow, to learn from? Or is it something that is going to make you feel handicapped? Grow. Then that is your belief. Then that's all you have to do. So when that happens, learn. Say, I take this on face. Bring it on. Everybody has been through something or the other in their lives. Every person has experienced a lot of sadness. People have experienced loss. We have also experienced love. We have also experienced joy. These are all just experiences. When it comes to what Ma'am was saying about main ichhaen meri yahan hai aur main yahan hoon, yes. That can make us feel disturbed and depressed and sad. But I am still here. So what do you want to do about that situation? Just stay there and say, but I'm sad because my aims are here. Or do you want to say, yes, awesome, my aims are here, I'm going to reach there. It's the way you look at those aims. It's not those aims being here. It's your attitude, your thinking, your thought process about those aims, about those desires you have. I may have a desire to drive a Mustang someday. Now, two ways to look at it. I can either feel sad and say, but I don't have a Mustang. How am I going to drive one? Or I say, I'm going to work hard. I'm going to make myself capable on my own. Do everything possible so I can drive a Mustang someday. And every day, as one good thing happens, I mark that in my checklist and say, okay, next.
Swati, you have 5 minutes more.
Right. So, Well, this is what I have to tell you about it. Coming to the exercises, because I have 5 minutes more. It's a very good book for everyone, and I would really recommend this book. This is called Healing Visualizations by Gerald Epstein, MD. So this is a book of visualizations that gives you visualization exercises for a lot of things. Insomnia, depression, headaches, guilt, addictions, anger, aimlessness, anxiety, stress. It has visualization exercises. Why visualization? Language of the subconscious mind. So if we want to work at the subconscious level, we need to know its language. Going to Japan, I need to know at least a little bit of Japanese so I can find my way around and not enter the elevator when I want to enter the toilet. As simple as that. Understanding the language of the subconscious mind. Visualizing. This book empowers you, and you can use them on yourself, or you can tell other people to use those exercises. It has a step-by-step thing of, you know, how to sit while you are doing visualizations, how to sit as you do your visualizations, how to breathe as you do, the correct way of breathing, which Dr. Shadajan has been emphasizing on right from the beginning of the session. Breathing correctly, breathing rightly. Right? Now, good? This has a wonderful technique on depression and what Dr. Gerald Epstein says about depression. He says depression in its various forms, grief, mourning, melancholy, sadness, brooding, moodiness and the like, is clearly the world's most ubiquitously experienced chronic emotional disorder. In a large number of cases, these various forms are directly related to loss and or self-directed anger. Self-directed. Most of us lose something every day. A person, an ideal, a thing, a plan, a dream, a success, a hope. Depending on the intensity of the loss, many of us react with one of the states mentioned above, such as grief or mourning. So, one of the best exercises that I have come across, and the easiest one here, to work with depression, is called the staircase of life. And it's for depression connected with repetitive thoughts. Usually, when we are depressed, we are thinking about something over and over and over and over. So this is called the staircase of life. Do you want to try it with me? It's only a 3 minutes, 4 minutes exercise. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So now, for this, you need to put your feet flat on the ground. Both your feet flat on the ground. Keeping your back and neck straight. Placing your hands on your legs. Like this. Okay, just around the bed. Good. Good to go, everyone? Right. And those who are standing right now and who cannot do it, they can just close their eyes wherever they are. Take leke aram se khade rahiye, koi dikkat nahi. Close your eyes and try to visualize for you. See? Good. Now, you are going to breathe out 3 times through your mouth by breathing in first through your nose and exhaling through your mouth. And your exhalation will be longer than the inhalation. Right? Close your eyes. Breathe in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. One more time. Exhale slowly. Very slowly, very slowly. Relax. Good. One more time. Breathe in. Exhale very slowly. Good. And now with your eyes closed, imagine, sense, feel. See yourself in a large mansion. Make it as large as you possibly can. Make it as real, as beautiful as you want to. It's your mansion. Note everything that you see and feel as you look at this mansion. And now see yourself that you were standing on top of this mansion. The very top. High above. Observe the view. And now see yourself descending the back staircase of this mansion. You're coming down the back staircase of this mansion. Coming down. Note every single thing you see and feel. come down, down, coming down, that's right. Good, just a few more steps maybe, and all the way down. And now you come around the front of the mansion and see yourself ascending the front staircase. Go up the front staircase of the mansion. And as you climb up the front staircase, notice whatever you see and feel. And as you come at the top of this mansion, the very top, you're almost there. Go on. Go on. Good. Higher. And as you get to the very top of it, see what you find there for yourself and keep it. It could be anything, big or small, material or immaterial. A feeling, maybe. When you find it, keep it. Take your time. Whenever you feel that you are ready to, take a deep breath in and open your eyes. By Dr. Gerald Epstein.
So, see, where it is available?
How do you use them?
Amazon.
Epstein. So, the staircase is to be done. It says the frequency is every 2 hours. But not more than 6 times per day for 2 to 3 minutes until you find relief. Using this exercise for yourself, even if you're feeling a general sense of sadness, just use this exercise. Because all that you are doing is breathing, visualizing, talking to your subconscious mind in its own language, and your subconscious mind feels, oh, finally, where have you been? Yes. It's all about here.
One thing I want.
Yes,
to
sir.
In fact, I could not visualize the mansion.
Okay, so here is the thing. Not everybody is visual.
However,
perfectly fine.
I tried.
Yeah.
But I could not.
Not everybody is visual. That's absolutely fine.
Others may have other experiences.
Right. Now, there are three ways of experiencing. I'll quickly let you know there are three ways of experiencing.
Practice.
I only have 2 minutes more. I'll be gone. I only have 2 minutes more, and I'll be gone.
Please.
Thanks. So, not everybody is visual. There are three ways to perceive information subconsciously. Visual, yes, of course. Now, that is a language that probably you have not been in touch with for a very long time, and it's okay. It's perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with it. Then there's auditory. Some people are auditory beings. Kuch logon ko sun ke kuch log zyada acche se wo kar paate, create kar paate. Some people are kinesthetic, which means feeling. Sensations. So, if you were not able to visualize it, what you can probably do is, if you may be auditory, try to think, if I am in a place like that, which is a mansion, what would the surroundings sound like? Is it in a desert? So if it's in a desert, maybe I can hear the desert storm somewhere. If it's at the beach, I can hear the ocean somewhere. So that sound of the sea. And then maybe as you focus on that sound, slowly you think. Creating is also fine. It may not come naturally, so you create it. Visual ko aur strong karne ke liye, one thing that you can do is whatever you want to visualize. Some ways Google is wonderful. Huh? Check out the images of that thing that you want to visualize. So mansion, search for a mansion on Google. Pick up the image that resonates the most with you. Focus on the word resonate, because resonation comes from here. You look, bahut saari images aati hai. It's like shopping. One bag that I want. No, this is the bag that I like, so this is the one that I like. It's like that. This image I'm resonating with. This is creating some vibrations in me. So you keep that image, close your eyes and try to draw it in front of your eyes with your eyes closed. Try to think about it. Slowly as you practice, 2 days, 3 days, maximum 4. Fifth day, I guarantee you will perfect visualize it.
That means you have to concentrate on something.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Focus. So, as you focus,
ki murti pe concentrate kar lo.
Some small way, even if I made 1% difference today.
No.